encouraging word of today. Today is Monday, November the 16th. And we're going to pick up here in the wonderful word of God in James chapter 1 and verses 12 through 16. Verses 12 through 16. We are living in a day and age of temptation all around us. There are so many things pulling at our heartstrings. There are so many things that are pining for our attention. There are things that our flesh longs after, and we are being tempted to follow the desires of that flesh. But I want you to know that it's not a sin to be tempted, as we can definitely see from the temptation of Jesus Christ in the wilderness by the devil himself. The devil tempted him, the Bible says, and yet he was without sin. Temptation is not a sin. To follow through with that temptation is a sin. So to think the wrong thing is not necessarily sin in itself. It's when we allow that wrong thought to continue to progress forward. Because we all are tempted to think things that aren't right. But the Bible says that we're to bring every thought captive unto the obedience of Christ Jesus. We may not always think correctly, but we can act correctly in spite of the way we think. So just because we think it, even though it may be an evil thought, we don't follow it off into sin until we act upon that thought in reality. And I'm going to show you the truth of this today as we look here in James chapter 1 and verse 12, here beginning. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. God says, you are blessed if you can handle and not fall into the temptation that comes your way. You're going to be a blessed person. Why? Listen to what he says. I love this. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life. Every time that we overcome that temptation, we're just showing that we have been given the crown of life, everlasting life. We have overcome sin and the flesh. We have overcome the tempter's snares to trip us up and to make us fall. But then he says this, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. It's not only in the moment that you get the sense of reward and that you have overcome a temptation that's come your way, but you're going to have a reward that's going to last forever and ever and ever in the kingdom of heaven. And that is going to be a joyous thing. And so he says he's going to give that reward to all of those because he has promised it to them that love him. And then verse 13, he says, let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempt he any man. No temptation comes from God. It comes from the flesh and the devil and the world that we live in. And we have to be able to discern what is good and what is evil. And the Bible says that we've come to know that as it was in the days of Adam and Eve in the garden when they chose to sin. And after the repercussions and the consequences laid out because of sin, the Bible says that God run them out of the Garden of Eden. He says they have come to know good and evil. They have come to know good and evil. And certainly as we grow up and become into adults, we do learn the difference between good and evil. We may ignore and relabel what is evil, as the Bible says they will come to call evil good and good evil. Certainly we're doing that in this generation. But we do come to know, and deep down inside, we know that we are doing wrong. We know that we're doing wrong. We just ignore it. And we push right on through and we go through. But whatever we're facing, whatever the temptation is to sin, it doesn't come from God. Now, God will allow us to be tested, but he doesn't tempt us. And there's a difference. God tests our faith to see if we're holding true to the things that we confess with our mouths. But he's not tempting us with evil. He allows us to be tested through the evil, but he's not the one tempting us. He's the one testing us. There's a difference. And so the devil tempts us into sin, but God tests us to stand faithfully against it. And so we have those two great comparisons. But now listen to what he says, because temptation doesn't come from God. Here's what he says. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. So the devil, he's like that great fisherman. He knows he's got a whole tackle box of all kinds of lures. And when he goes out and goes fishing, what he does is he continues to switch that lure, switch that bait until he finds the bait that the fish are going to bite. That is the tactic of the devil. He tempts us in many different ways. And yet we can look it dead in the face and say, I'm not biting that. I'm not going that way. I see you there tempting me. And man, my flesh, boy, it's tough to turn that away, but I'm going to do so because I do not want to come into sin. I do not want to do that which is of the flesh, which is brings me to destruction. I want to live in everlasting life. And so that is a blessing. So he says it only comes, temptation is comes when we are drawn away and enticed by the devil to fall into sin. But then look what he says, verse 15.